me, Ahmed Abdel Latif, coming to you from speaklikeanegyptian.com. Welcome to this new Egyptian Arabic video. Today, I will be teaching you the meanings of the most common used Egyptian Arabic names. But before we go to this, make sure to thumb up, press subscribe, and activate the ring button to be notified with all my new videos. And let's go very quickly for this. And definitely, we have male names and female names. Male names are the first names that we're gonna be discussing today. And actually, male names has two concepts to be considered, which they are religious concepts. We have a saying that says that best names that are Humida and Ubida. Humida means have the concept of thanking. Ubida has the concept of slaving. You may think the concept of slaving is something bad, which is yes, being a slave is something bad, but I have here something to clarify. Allah, which is our God, He has 100 names. One of them, for example, is the Mercy. Got it? So if I'm called the slave of the mercy, so I'm a slave for something good, which is something we do recommend. Okay, so let us go now with the common male names. So let's go to the first group, which consists of four names that are linked to the word Humida, which is hamd, which is thanking. You know when someone tells you ازيك, you reply back by saying Alhamdulillah. This is what I mean by Humida. So for example, Ahmed, Muhammad, Mahmoud, and Hamid. These four names are very, very, very common in Egypt, are very repetitive in Egypt. Ahmed, Muhammad, Mahmoud, Hamid. And both of them, or actually four of them, are related to the concept of thanking. Then let's move to another name, the name Mustafa, which is the nickname here in Egypt. We call him Darash. Darash. It got nothing to do with the name Mustafa, I know, but the word Mustafa means very selective. So if someone, his name is Mustafa, so you should know that he has the character of being very selective. And then another very common name in Egyptian Arabic, which is the name Khalid. Khalid. Khalid, which means long living person. Long living person. Yes, long living person is called Khalid. And another very common name here in Egypt, which is the name Hamza. Hamza is one of the names that we call the line. So Hamza means line. Definitely, line is Asad in MSA and in Egyptian Arabic, but still we can call the line as Hamza. So if someone his name is Hamza, that means he's a line. And then the name Ibrahim. Ibrahim. Ibrahim comes from the word Ab, which means father. So the whole thing, Ibrahim means the father of group of people. Someone who have a commitment to a group of people. Someone who has a responsibility toward a group of people. So it's Ibrahim. Ibrahim. And finally, for the male group of names, the name Omar. Omar. Omar comes from the word age. Age, which is actually my son, his name is Omar. So his name has the name age. So Omar is age. Then let's move to the female names. First name, we're gonna be discussing the name Dalia. Dalia. Dalia actually has many meanings, but the very well-known meaning means the highest point of a grapes tree. Highest point of a grapes tree, we call it Dalia. Dalia. And another name, the name Sahar. 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 It's not ha, it's ha. Sahar. Okay. Sahar, it's the last moments of the night. So I'm talking about like 4 or 5 a.m. These are the last moments of the night, we call it Sahar. And then two names that are related to each other, the name Aya and Ayat. What's Aya and Ayat? Aya, it's a singular word, Ayat, it's a plural word. Okay, still, what does that mean? Aya is part, or actually it's like a sentence of the Quran. So one Aya is a sentence of a Quran. Ayat is many sentences or many parts of the Quran. So we have Aya and Ayat. And then the last three names, the first name of the last three is the name Omniya, which means hope or wish. You know, you're wishing something, so this is called Omniya. It's also one of the very good names as the meaning as well. And the two last names, first name is called Gamila. Gamila. Gamila means beautiful or beauty. جميلة. But it's a quite old style name, but it has a very nice meaning, which is جميلة. Imagine calling a girl جميلة as you're calling a girl, or actually a girl's name is beauty or beautiful. Got it? So it's one of the most names I like as well, and it has a nice meaning, but it's a quite old style or old school name. And finally, the name Sara. Sara. Sara comes from the word surur, which is happiness. So Sara comes from the word happiness, Sara, which is just like the English name or the American name Sarah, but in Egyptian Arabic we say it as Sara, Sara. Okay, that's all for now. I just clarified to you some meanings of some names in Egyptian Arabic and even in Fusha Arabic, which is called MSA. Thank you very much for watching. And if you are interested in private classes with me, make sure to WhatsApp me at the written below number or simply mail me at info@speaklikeegyptian.com. Thank you very much for watching and see you in another video. Assalamu alaikum.